Hi students, this is Dr. Sivakant Pathak. These two new topic, that is uniform circular motion. This is new lecture, new part we are going to see. We have seen motion in one dimension, two dimension and three dimension with projectile motion. Now we are going to give uniform circular motion a new concept. Here the object will move in a circular path. Let a body moves in circular path with constant speed. Let it is a center. A particle is moving in a circular path here in this. It denotes a radius of it. With a constant speed during the motion, let's say its position is from here to here. When it's moved from A to B according to the diagram here, see, here are two physical quantity. One is speed and another is velocity. Here the difference between these two physical quantities required to understand clearly. Speed is a scalar quantity, whereas velocity is vector quantity. It means speed has a magnitude, velocity has a magnitude and a direction both. The body is moving with constant speed. It means any point in the path of circular path, the body has a constant speed, but we can't, this is not for a velocity. Let's see what is a velocity at B. So make a velocity vector, draw a tangent at a point A. This length denotes the magnitude and head denotes direction. Let at A velocity is V1. Now see velocity at B, so draw another tangent at point B. See it is, the direction, the head denotes the direction and length denotes its magnitude. See here, vector V1 is not equal to vector V2. Why? Although their magnitude are same. Both of bodies moving in same direction, same speed in the circular motion. So its speed is constant throughout the motion, but velocity is changing every positions due to change the direction. It means the direction at every point in the journey is changing. So, speed is a constant, but velocity is variable. So, it is, see very carefully, this is, speed is constant, whereas velocity is variable. Look, this body which moving from A to B, it travels delta S arc from here to here, and the distance here in the diagram, angular distance theta, it arc. So there is a relation between angle and arc in the geometry, that is angle is equal to arc by radius. Here angle is theta, arc is delta s and radius is r. It is a relation in geometry which gives relation between radius, arc and angle. This angle is known as theta, is known as in the physics here in this chapter angular displacement. See here in this equation carefully. Here delta s by r and theta, in the case if it's rotate one complete cycle, the time taken to revolve a complete path, one complete cycle time, is called time period. This is called time period and it is represented by t. If it's move from here in anticlockwise direction and again reach at point A, in that condition angular displacement is 360 degree 2 pi. And time taken equal to time period, that is the capital T. So if it's move here in a circular path and we want to calculate angular velocity, it is angular distance by angular time. This omega is equal to 2 pi by t. This is the second definition. Angular distance can also be obtained by, here in the diagram, see carefully the diagram here in circular path. When a body, its position is here at point A, when time is zero, at time t1, suppose it's move at point B, from A to B in time t1, and its travel angular displacement theta1, and in t2 time it travels from A to C. How much time take its t2 time is from A to B and it's move at position now C, then let angular displacement is theta2. If you want to calculate if body moves from B to C, the time interval is interval delta t is equal to t2 minus t1, then in this time let its travel distance angular displacement delta theta, this delta theta is equal to theta2 minus theta1. In delta t time its travel delta t distance, so angular velocity delta omega can also be written as angular displacement by angular time. And if we take a limit, this angular velocity we can represent by not a delta omega, angular velocity is total omega, it is limit delta t tends to 0, delta theta by delta t, and here in differential equation it is denoted by dq by dt. This is one more formula. Now see another part here. Very carefully. That is a small subheading. Relation between linear velocity and angular velocity. It's clear? Now see equation 1 we are using, where theta denotes angular displacement, angular displacement. Here this equation number 1, theta is equal to delta s by r. This was equation number 1. Now angular displacement, if for a short angular displacement the theta can be represented as delta t. Now divide by delta t both sides. It can be mathematically written, it has no different mean. If you are taking here delta s, so here delta theta will be used. So if you divide delta t on both sides, so in left side delta theta upon delta t is equal to 1 by r delta s by delta t. See very carefully. Taking limit both side here, so it's become limit delta theta by delta t, delta t tends to 0 is equal to 1 by r limit delta t tends to 0 delta s by delta t. See in mathematics it is called delta theta by d theta by dt is equal to 1 by r, it is ds by dt. See here in the diagram, if it's move from v1 to v2 and if it's travel very small distance, now if it is used delta s here delta theta can be used here in the case. So here delta, if it is very small, or especially we can see in the second diagram more clearly, delta theta, if it is very small, then this arc can be treated as a straight line. In that condition, d theta by dt is known as omega. By equation 3, 1 by r ds by dt denotes v. ds by dt, distance by time is called linear velocity. So it is omega by v by r, or v is equal to r omega. This is one more relation, equation number 4. Now we are going to see one more topic, that is centripetal acceleration. See why its name acceleration we are already knowing in linear velocity. Linear motion, that is motion in one dimension. But here is a centripetal acceleration. To see it, see very carefully what is centripetal acceleration here in the case. Before watching the mean of centripetal, let us find out the acceleration mathematically first of all. Once we are able to obtain the acceleration formula, thereafter in the last we will see why this acceleration is called centripetal acceleration. The chapter is uniform circular motion, in which a body is moving in uniform circular path. Uniform circular path means with constant speed, but not constant velocity. Let us see a body moves in a circular path which radius is r, moves from A to B. From A to B. This is also distance r. While it's traveling from A to B, it travel arc delta s. From A to B. In that condition, it travels angular displacement delta theta. Let this point is clear, everybody. See carefully. Body moves from A to B. Particle moves from A to B. A to B. Here in circular motion with constant speed. But see, what is a velocity at position A and B? To know the velocity, let us draw tangent at point A. Length of tangent denotes velocity, head denotes direction. Now draw tangent at point B. Let body is moving anti-clockwise. Particle is moving in a circular path in anti-clockwise. So at point B, see the tangent, its velocity is V2 and direction here in this side. See, velocity changes although speed is a constant. So velocity changes due to change in direction. Now see, we are going to make a supportive diagram here in the case. Here we are going to calculate acceleration here in the case. So acceleration is rate of change of velocity dv by dt, or acceleration is equal to delta v by delta t. Rate of change of velocity. So here we want to see, calculate change in velocity. So for showing the change in velocity, this change in velocity is V2 minus V1. See very carefully. This V2 minus V1 we will obtain by vector diagram. So this is a vector V2. Same size in the same direction. See clearly. Minus V1. V1 is in this side, minus V1 just opposite. This V1. V2 minus V1. Now join from here to here. This denotes change in velocity. It is V2 minus V1 vector. See carefully, give the name here X, Y, Z. This change in velocity is due to, see here in the diagram, change in velocity delta V is due to change in distance travel or due to change in delta theta. That's why we have two triangle, that is O A B. O A B, triangle O A B and triangle XYZ similar. These two triangles are similar. Why similar? here two lengths are same, here also V1, V2 in magnitude are same. Delta V is due to delta S. This angle is due to angular displacement, so it is a similar. Now see, if these two triangles are similar, these triangles are OAB and triangle XYZ, then we are going to apply the property of similarity. In the case, we will take AB with XY. So AB ratio XY is equal to, the similar property is OB ratio XY. OB ratio XY, AB is here delta S, delta S by XY is delta V is equal to OB is R and XY is V. This V is magnitude of first vector is equal to magnitude of second vector because speed is constant or uniform. It travels with uniform speed. So here cross multiplication delta S into V is equal to delta V into R. Now divide by delta T both side, then delta S by delta T into V is equal to delta V by delta T into R. Taking limit both side, so now it is limit delta S by delta T into V, delta T tends to 0 is equal to limit delta T tends to 0 delta V by delta T into R. Since this factor is velocity, we can write it as ds by dt is equal to, this factor is dv by dt into R. It is a linear velocity V into V, and it is acceleration, rate of change of velocity into R. This implies that A is equal to V square by R. This is called acceleration, right? This is called acceleration. Now, we are also knowing that since V is equal to R omega, so now we can keep A is equal to R square omega square by R, yeah, R omega square. This acceleration is equal to R omega square. We have two formula here available to determine the formula of acceleration. Now one thing is, this is a way to calculate the acceleration. Since acceleration is scalar quantity, velocity is also vector quantity. Velocity at every point it is a variable. This variability is due to change in direction at every point. When we draw a tangent at every point on the path, its direction is a changes. So direction changes mean velocity changes. Velocity changes means velocity can only be changed by acceleration. That is why we have calculated mathematically acceleration, that is V square by R or R omega square. Since acceleration is a vector quantity, so this acceleration has also directions. This acceleration which acts, it is neither in a linear motion. Acceleration normally acts either in the direction of velocity when it increases the velocity, or just opposite to the a velocity, a case in which it decreases normally. But here in a circular motion, this acceleration is not along in the direction of velocity, nor just opposite, but it towards the center, this acceleration. That is why this acceleration is called centripetal acceleration. This more concept we will see in the second lecture when we will start centripetal force in the uniform circular motion. Then we will see in a detail. This is for today. Thank you and have a nice day to all.